Next is the consequences of ozone depletion. There are several consequences. Skin cancer is the major. Then we have swelling of the skin. Then we have the cataract of the eyes. Leukemia problem also. Then we have cancer, burning sensation on the skin. And we have lungs cancer and lungs injury problem due to this ultraviolet light which is reaching the earth surface. Depletion of the ozone layer has been observed in the Arctic region, where a big hole has been reported, which is known as ozone hole. This I have told you just now. Now the need for the substitute, since we know that we cannot stop the cooling industry, we cannot stop the refrigeration industry, we cannot stop. Therefore, what we need is that to replace this chlorofluorocarbon with some other alternative which has zero ozone depletion potential and which has all the properties or better properties than the chlorofluorocarbon. Therefore, scientists and researchers, they have invented or discovered some other compounds which has better cooling property. These are environmental friendly and they do not cause much threat to the ozone layer. These compounds are HCFC. Now, what do we mean by HCFC? This is known as hydrochlorofluorocarbons. And HFC, which is another term known as hydrofluorocarbons, they are used as substitute for CFC and in the refrigeration and air conditioning units. One most common HCFC is hydrochlorofluorocarbons 22 has been used as refrigerant for several decades. HCFC has zero ozone depletion potential. Therefore, this was all about the ozone. I have spoken about this importance of the ozone. What are the major factors which are responsible for the depletion of the ozone layer? Then we have studied about the chemical reactions which are taking for the formation and the depletion of ozone in the stratosphere. We have also seen some of the chemical reactions which results in the depletion of ozone layer by freons, which are known as chlorofluorocarbons. Similarly, we have seen that supersonic aircraft has been US has stopped flying this supersonic aircraft because these aircraft, when they fly at a great height, at a height of stratosphere, then they deplete the ozone layer. Another cause was atomic explosion, and aerosols cans have also been discontinued, and there were several consequences of this depletion of the ozone layer, because if this ozone layer is getting thinner or depleted, then maximum concentration of the UV light is reaching the earth surface, which is causing major threat to the environment. Next topic which I am going to discuss with you is about the water pollution. We already have read about the air pollution, and we have seen that whenever there is an alteration in physical, chemical and biological property of the air due to addition of unwanted, undesirable foreign substance, then it was said to be air pollution. Similar definition can be for water pollution also. In this topic, we will see that what are the various sources of water supply on this earth, how the pollution is caused due to natural source, due to man-made source, what are the various effects of water pollution on the human life, plant life and to the environment. Let us first discuss about the definition part of this water pollution. We know that about 1/3 of the earth's surface is covered with water, and without water life is impossible. Water is the basis of our life, because it is not only used for drinking purpose, cooking purpose or for household purpose, but majority of the water is used for industry also. Almost all the industries on this earth utilizes water for one process or the another process. Therefore, water being plenty on this earth can be polluted very easily, because being plenty, it has non-poisonous nature. It is known as universal solvent because it can dissolve and sustain inorganic substances, it can dissolve and sustain organic substances, it can retain the heat also, it can hold various radionuclides also and various other suspended and dissolved impurities in the water. Therefore, the major sources of the air pollution will come later on, but first we will start about the definition. Any alteration in physical, chemical and biological property of the water due to addition of unwanted, undesirable substance which cause a health hazard or decrease its utility, it is called water pollution. What are the signs of water pollution? Basically means that bad taste of the drinking water, presence of colored impurities in the water, oil and grease floating on the surface of water. Then we have various suspended impurities which are seen in the water. There we have offensive odor or smell in the water. All these factors, they are a sign of the water pollution. But let us come to this. What are the sources of drinking water? Drinking water, there are basically two sources, two broad sources. First one, it is said to be surface water supply. Another one, it is said to be underground water supply. Of the two sources, surface water is more prone to pollution because it flows in the rivers, it is accumulated in the lakes also, in the ponds also. But the underground water supply, they are found in the wells, and it is through the seepage of the water from the earth, and it goes through the different layers of the soil or rocks, and various impurities they are trapped in the different layers of the soil or the earth, and the water which is found beneath the earth or the underwater, it is more clean and clear. Therefore, a basic difference between the two is that surface water is prone to more pollution. But though there has been a contamination or the pollution of the underground water sources also, this may will come later on. Let us proceed to the next slide. Contaminants can be classified as, these can be classified as dissolved inorganic salts, dissolved organic compounds. Then we have microorganisms, various microorganisms, because during rainy season we suffer from various diseases such as typhoid, cholera, then we have jaundice, then we have dysentery. So therefore, water has a tendency to hold various microorganisms like bacteria, virus. Then we have suspended particles including colloids, and we have pyrogens, and then radioactive waste. These are the utilization of the water, which is already I have spoken about, that it is the essential commodity for survival. Then we need water for drinking, cooking, bathing, for irrigation purpose also. Most of the water comes from the rivers, lakes and groundwater source. Pollution can be caused from two main sources, point source and non-point source. And groundwater is less prone to pollution because water passes through various layers of the soil. And however, a number of potential sources of groundwater pollution are septic tanks which are there. We have industrial waste from the textile industry, chemical industry, from the mining waste also. Therefore, now the impurities in the water. Let us discuss about the dissolved inorganics. It includes the salts which causes hardness of water. Hardness is the property which prevents leather formation with the soap. It is basically due to presence of carbonates and bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium, and similarly due to chlorides and sulfates of calcium and magnesium along with several other salts. Therefore, these are the dissolved inorganic substances. Iron salts from rusting of the iron pipes. Then we have phosphate from detergents, nitrate from fertilizers, and compounds of toxic metals such as lead and mercury. We have also water soluble nitrates and phosphates compound which cause excess growth of the alga and aquatic plants, and this problem is known as eutrophication. I'll come to this point in my next slide. What are the dissolved organic compounds? these includes oxygen demanding waste, then disease causing agents, plants, nutrients, then sewage. It's the organic impurities are also due to decay of plants and animals, chemicals from farming, paper making, oil, plastic, pesticides, and various other solvents also. Microorganisms, I already told, disease causing pathogens which spread waterborne diseases. We have suspended particles in the soil particles, clay, silt, which remain suspended in the water, and these causes turbidity and they reduce the photosynthesis by plants. Similarly, we have radioactive waste also. From atomic explosion, the radioactive waste is released which causes water pollution problem. Major water sources of water pollution, industrial effluent which is released from the industry, from various industries, I have already spoken about this. Domestic sewage, yes, of course, it consists of various microorganisms, disease producing bacteria, germs, and then we have waste, these chemicals coming out from the fertilizers and pesticides from agricultural lands, then leachate from solid water disposal sites. This is also one of the major sources of water pollution. These pollutants can be classified, these sources of water pollution can be classified into two types. First one, it is said to be point source, other one it is said to be a non-point source. In this point source means that these discharge pollutants at specific location through pipes, ditches, sewers, and majority the factories are the main source of this pollution. Then we have non-point source means that these are big land areas that discharge pollutants into surface and underground water. For example, runoff into surface water and seepage into ground, these are the two major broad sources. Then it comes to the surface water pollution, sewage, pouring the contents of drain and sewers into fresh water bodies. Then we have industrial effluent containing acid, alkalis, phenols, cyanides, various other dangerous compounds. And the heat is also released into the water bodies due to thermal pollution. We have also agrochemicals like fertilizers which consist of nitrates and phosphates, and pesticides, basically insecticides, fungicides, herbicides, which are washed by the rainwater and pollute the main water supply. Oil, yes, of course, the transportation of the oil is also one of the major source of water pollution. Oil spillage into seawater, whenever there is leakage from the oil drilling industry or the shipment, the oil flows on the surface of the water and cause marine pollution. Now comes the effect of water pollution. We have seen that these pollutants are mainly added from the point source, non-point source, and they make the water unfit for drinking purpose, and they are harmful to the aquatic life also. So what is the effect of these pollutants on the aquatic ecosystem? We know that the amount of dissolved oxygen which is there in the water, the concentration is 4 mg per liter to 8 mg per liter, means that 4 ppm parts per million to 8 parts per million. So above this and below this range, both cases are harmful for the aquatic organism, because decrease in the DO content of the water, it will certainly affect the photosynthetic activity. Then we have oxygen consumption by organism, decomposition of organic matter. These are the factors which determine the amount of DO. Therefore, this permissible limit should be there. Water having DO content below 8 mg per liter is considered to be contaminated, and below 4 mg per liter is said to be highly polluted. Therefore, DO, dissolved oxygen, is a very important water quality parameter. Both cases is harmful. Above 8 it is contaminated, and below 4 mg per liter it is highly polluted. Therefore, it is very important water quality parameter. The higher the amount of this inorganic and organic waste, the more active will be the microorganism for the digestion of this waste. Therefore, they will need more of the oxygen, and when they will consume more of the oxygen, the amount of DO or the dissolved oxygen decreases in the water bodies, and therefore it will have major effect on the aquatic life also, on the plant life also. And when the higher the value of BOD, biological oxygen demand, and low will be the DO content of the water. Sometimes in the absence of dissolved oxygen or the less quantity of dissolved oxygen, the decomposers, they undergo anaerobic oxidation for the degradation of the material present in the water, and due to which various harmful substances are released into the water body, or they call foul smell in the water bodies. The contamination of water bodies by pollutants reduces DO content, that is dissolved oxygen. A few species like tubifex or annelid worm are some insect larvae which may survive in highly polluted water with low DO contents, dissolved oxygen content. Such species are recognized as indicator species for polluted water. Comes to the next slide. Biocides, polychlorinated biphenyls. Then we have heavy metals such as mercury, lead, cadmium, copper, arsenic directly eliminate certain species of organism. Hot water which is discharged from the industry when added to the water bodies also lowers the dissolved oxygen content, which is known as thermal pollution, and it affects the marine and the plant life also. Let us come to this topic, which is known as eutrophication. Eutrophication means that addition of inorganic compounds and decomposition of organic waste in the water body increases the nutrient content of the water. This results in the profuse or the algal growth, increase in the algal growth like blue-green alga, which totally covers the surface of the water body. And this type of algal growth is known as algal bloom. It releases various toxins in the water which inhibit the growth of other algae. Aquatic animals like fishes may also die due to toxicity or the lack of oxygen. The process of nutrient enrichment of water, which often leads to the loss of species diversity, is known as eutrophication problem. You must have seen in the Udaipur also some of the lakes, there is an increase in the growth of blue-green alga or water hyacinth, which is known as jalkumbhi, which entirely covers the surface of the water. Therefore, the sunlight cannot penetrate deep in the water. The concentration of the dissolved oxygen also decreases in the water, and it results in the loss of various other aquatic and the marine life. Therefore, eutrophication is the process of addition of nutrients to the water body, which increases the growth of blue-green alga. It releases various toxic substances in the water, and which may cause death of the several aquatic and the plant life. Next comes the phenomenon which is there. It is known as bioamplification or the biomagnification. We see that various pollutants get accumulated in the tissues in increasing concentration along with the food chain. This is known as biological magnification. We have been using DDT, which is known as dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane. It is one of the pesticides which we are using. It is non-degradable, and the average life of DDT is expected to be 50 to 70 years. Therefore, they are absorbed by the organism. They cannot be metabolized, and they cannot be broken down or excreted out. These pollutants or pesticides or DDT get accumulated in fat-containing tissues of the organism, and due to which, I'll give you the case history that after regular spray of DDT for a few years in Long Island in USA, the population of fish-eating birds begin to decline. The cause of decline in the birds was biomagnification or the bioamplification, that is these organic chemicals which are non-degradable, they are accumulated in the fats and tissues, and they pass on from one generation to the another generation. Now see the effect on human health. A number of health hazards are caused due to various types of pollutants which are present in the water. Basically, waterborne diseases, which we have already read about, the jaundice, it causes jaundice, cholera, typhoid, amoebosis, etc. Various heavy metals, certainly these are released from the industry. Mercury compounds in wastewater are converted by bacterial action into extremely toxic methyl mercury, which can cause numbness of limbs and tongues, deafness, blurring of vision, and mental problem also, that is it affects the central nervous system. And one deadly disease has been observed in Japan, which is known as Minamata disease, and it is due to the contamination of the water due to mercury or the mercury salts, where thousands of people died in Japan. This is known as Minamata tragedy. We also see that water contaminated with cadmium caused another disease, which is known as Itai disease or Auchauch disease, painful disease of the bones and the joints. Then we have cancers, lungs, and the liver problem also. The compounds of lead causes anemia, headache, and bluish line along the gums. Therefore, you see that we have dangerous effect of these water pollutants, which are released from the industries, which are released from the man-made source. Now see, let us discuss about the hazards of the groundwater pollution. Basically, the presence of excess of nitrate in drinking water is very dangerous for human health, because the hemoglobin, which is present in the blood, which is responsible for carrying oxygen to different parts of our body, in the presence of nitrate, it forms methemoglobin, and which is unable to carry oxygen. This disease is called methemoglobinemia or blue baby syndrome. Another source of pollution for the groundwater is the fluoride. The fluorine in drinking water causes teeth deformity, basically hardening of the bones and stiffness of the bone, and it causes skeletal fluorosis also. Over-exploitation of the groundwater may lead to the leaching of arsenic from soil and rocks and contaminate the groundwater. We have seen that chronic exposure to arsenic causes black foot disease or peripheral neuritis, hyperkeratosis, and also lungs and skin cancer are observed due to this arsenic poisoning also. Last, we will discuss about this control of water pollution. How can we control these water pollutants? Judicious use of agrochemicals like pesticides and fertilizer. Use of nitrogen fixing plants to supplement the use of fertilizers. Adopting integrated pest management to reduce the reliance on pesticides. We can emphasize on integrated pest management, IPM technique. Prevent runoff manures. We can divert runoff to basin for settlement, and we can have a separate drainage channel for sewage and drain to prevent the overflow of sewage with rainwater. Planting trees can also reduce water pollution, because it will prevent the soil erosion. For controlling water pollution from point source, treatment of wastewater is essential before it is discharged. Then we have advanced treatment for removal of nitrogen phosphate, which will prevent eutrophication problem. Before the discharge of wastewater, it should be disinfected to kill the disease-causing organisms. Proper chlorination of the water can be done. Water hyacinth and aquatic weeds can purify water by taking some toxic chemicals and a number of heavy metals from water. Oil skins in water can be cleaned with the help of Rigoli, a byproduct of paper industry resembling sawdust. It will adsorb water on its surface. Hot water should be cooled before release from the power plant, otherwise it will cause thermal pollution problem. Washing clothes and bathing directly into stream water should be avoided. The industrial effluent should be properly treated before release into the water. The process requires different steps depending on the nature of pollutants, and together we can control this water pollution. Thank you. We'll discuss another topic in my next lecture. Thank you so much.